things became more difficult in the treatment when we went beyond behavioral adaptive traditional therapy, psychotherapy, into what they called aversive conditioning through the use of shock treatment. They connect electrodes to the palms of your hand, and when you become aroused, you receive a mild shock. If it's not working, the next step, in other words, you're not converting, the next step, as it was for me, is to apply the electrodes to your testicles, which is what I underwent. I was 13 years old. To be prodded like that, to share my body like that, and the most intimate parts of my thoughts and my nature and my fantasies, it was humiliating. I felt violated.
I endured, to heal homosexuality, you have to have male bonding. It's called healthy male bonding, which is non-sexual, and you learn how to be one of the guys and stay away from women. I did not talk to my mother and my sisters for 3 years, as I lived in the same house with them. This included the girls at school and so forth. I learned how to be a man on the idea of stereotype, how to be one of the guys, how to fit in, how to be a sports player, a stereotype of what a man is supposed to be. I had extreme depression. I started cutting school. I started not being at school, not being found at school. I contemplated suicide a lot. I expressed it to several friends at the time.
Is there a network of conversion therapists?
They are all networked together, New York City, New York State, and nationally. Almost all the New Yorkers have been suggested to go to Jonah, which is across the Hudson in Jersey City. They all know each other, they will recommend each other.
The first point is homosexuality, and with that LGBT. It's not a mental or medical disorder. Since the 1970s, the long-standing consensus of the behavior and social sciences and the health and mental health professionals is that homosexuality and bisexuality are per se normal and positive variations of human sexual orientations. The research consistently failed to provide any empirical or scientific basis for regarding homosexuality or bisexuality as a disorder or abnormality. Because of this, the major mental health professional organizations do not encourage individuals to try to change their sexual orientation. For these reasons, no major mental health professional organizations has sanctioned efforts to change sexual orientation, and virtually all of them have adopted policy statements cautioning the profession and the public about treatments that support the change of sexual orientation.
California, as mentioned, I helped draft the first state law prohibiting licensed mental health professionals from engaging in SOC with minors, and then defended the constitutionality of that law in two separate legal challenges in the federal district court and in the Ninth Circuit. That law is the model for the law enacted in New Jersey and other laws under consideration in states across the country, including here in New York.